do we have any good myths in the mailbox today?
Let me check. I think we have a good one. Okay, so it looks like this scientist is asking about trying to improve the efficiency in their lab.
Okay.
So they're trying to take the equipment that they have currently without buying any new HPLCs or modernizing their equipment. And they want to try to get better efficiency by using more modern columns. So things like smaller particle size, things like core shell columns. And they want to know if that will be as good as buying new equipment.
Ah, that's a good one. That's a good one because as column technologies come along, you know, we've seen with smaller particles and solid core materials, that's really driving efficiency.
Mm-hmm.
But you're right. Can you use those modern columns on older, maybe HPLC-like systems and get ultra performance?
Right. Is that going to be as good as something?
It's a great myth because a lot of the times you'll see this type of information in some sort of materials. They'll say, turn your HPLC into a UPLC.
I know, I've seen that.
All they're doing is just switching the column.
Right.
Let's test this one.
I think we can test this one.
All right, let's do it.
Okay.
I think the best way to test this myth, Kim, it'd be really simple. If we just look at the three systems that we have in our laboratory, we'll look at a UPLC, a UHPLC, and an HPLC.
Mm-hmm.
And we'll run on those systems some modern solid core chemistries and take a look at efficiency and what types of efficiencies we can get from these systems.
I think that's a good idea. We should also, though, think about different column dimensions because the column volume could also have an impact on the results that we see.
Great point, great point. Yeah, so I'll get some columns.
Mm-hmm.
We'll fire up our three systems and we'll just start seeing what we get for results.
All right, here we go.
Here we go. Kim, it was a great idea that you had to run the three different column configurations, a 2.1, a 3mm, and a 4.6 on these different systems, because the data is going to show that that really makes a difference. If you look first at the HPLC data that we ran these three columns on, you can see that from these linear velocity versus efficiency curves, that for the 4.6mm column, boy, you get the most efficiency. You almost get 8,000 plates. And as you decrease the internal diameter to 3 or even a 2.1, it really falls off. And if you look at the chromatography, it's terrible, especially for the 2.1 and the 3. The 4.6 is okay, but the 2.1 and the 3 is horrible. Now, if we look at the UHPLC data, boy, then we start to see a little bit better chromatography for the 3mm and the 4.6, but the 2.1, still not very good. And lastly, the UPLC system, all three columns have excellent efficiency, almost topping out at 12,000 plates.
All right, so these are the three exact same columns, just run on three different systems. We have drastically different plate counts or efficiencies, and it all depends on the system.
Yeah, the system is really doing a number on the efficiency, especially for the narrow bore columns, like the 2.1s.
So Jonathan, what's really making the difference in these systems? Why don't we see equivalent performance?
Sure, Kim. It's all about dispersion, or the system's dispersion, or how much contribution that system's actually doing in broadening that band. If you think about each system, they're all plumbed, you know, pretty differently as far as tubing lengths and tubing volumes. Also the flow cell, different volumes. The HPLC system, being a slightly older instrument, has a lot more volume inherent with the system. So that adds a lot more dispersion or band spreading to that column. So no matter how great of a column that is, you're never going to get the performance. And we measure the dispersion value of the systems. You can see that for the HPLC system, the dispersion value is roughly around 37 microliters. For the UHPLC system that we have in our lab is roughly 13 microliters. And for the UPLC system, it's roughly 4 microliters of dispersion. So the lower the dispersion value from the system, the better you are at getting the efficiency of that high efficient column.
Wow, so it's probably not a good idea to have 2 extra feet of tubing between the injection and the column, right?
No, extra tubing is terrible.
All right.
So based on our experiments, Kim, it's really important to be able to classify the systems that you have in your lab by their dispersion values. I mean, if you think about it, HPLC systems typically have greater than 30 microliters of dispersion. UHPLC systems have a dispersion range of roughly between 12 to 30 microliters. And ultra-performance or UPLC systems have dispersion values typically less than 12 microliters.
Right. So it's really important to know what your system dispersion is, and that can help guide you with choosing the proper column internal diameter that's going to match the system. So for example, if you're running an HPLC, a 4.6 millimeter ID column will work fine. If you're running a UHPLC, something with a little smaller dispersion, you could use a 3 millimeter ID. And if you're using a UPLC, something with really small dispersion, then you can consider using a 2.1 millimeter column really successfully. Okay, Jonathan, so we looked at the columns on three different systems. How do we want to call this one?
This is so busted. Oh. You cannot get ultra performance on an old system simply by replacing it with a modern column. The system won't allow you to get the efficiency advantages from that column. It's got too much dispersion in there, and it just, you won't get the expected efficiency gains. Even if you do match up the column internal diameter with what's best for that system, you'll still never get full ultra performance.
So a $700 column isn't going to make a high dispersion system perform like a low dispersion system.
Nope, it's not going to do it.
Okay, do you want to give them the bad news?
Yeah, I'll type it up, I'll send it off.
Okay. If you'd like your question to be answered on a future episode, please feel free to email us at trustyourscience@waters.com.